Hello friends, welcome to today's tutorials. And on this very tutorial, I'm just going to show you how you can insert, delete and update your table using PDO, right? So I'm just going to create a new database and table, right? So we use for this tutorial, and I'm going to use subline tests, and it's my www folder, right? So I'm going to create a new folder here, which is PDO, right? PDO. Okay, so create new files. Oh, sorry. Create your file, which is an index, and connection, right? So we have connection .php, right? And another file, which is index.php. Okay, so let's create the database and the table as well. So I'm click on new, and so we change the data type, and I'm in here just set the length, which is the ID. Okay, and then I'll set the auto increment and the primary key as well. So click on save. Oh, sorry. PDO underscore table. Done creating the table, right? So let's try and connect some database here using the try and catch, right? So try and catch, and get message. PDO exception, and let's define the variables, which is a host local have the username, which is equal to root, have the password, and we also have the DB name, right? This PDO. So I'm connect equals our new PDO. Set the host to the variable host. DB name equals our DB name, right? DB name. Have the username and the password as well. So connect sets attributes So we are going to use we are going to work on the index dot XML, right? So in here just add the PHP tags and let's include or require connection.php, right? So let's run this. So local host slash PDO. So in, I want us to try to insert data inside our table first using PDO, right? So I'm going to show you how you can do that. I'm not going to use input fields, I'm just going to set some variables and insert it, right? So let me declare some variables here, which is our first name. Okay, so let's try to insert this data inside the database, right? So maybe my PDO equals PDO the connect prepare the insert. The first name and you have the surname and you have the username, right? So the values just put in question mark. So maybe I'm going to store some array here, those values inside my array, right? So array and first name, have the surname, and also have the username, right? Okay, so PDO. Then I pass in the array variable, right? Okay, so let me try this. Okay, so you can see we have inserted this data, right? So what I did was, so if maybe you are using you want to get a field from the user, just put in a variable underscore then post, right? Use the post to get the username and then the first name, surname as well. So in here just store the variables in an array according to how your table looks like, right? So that's how you are going to insert it, right? So I'm going to show you another way how you can delete and maybe update as well, right? So you can comment this out. Okay, so I want us to update what we just inserted, right? So the connect, then you prepare, right? Prepare, then update. table, set first name, course, surname equals this, right? Then maybe where the ID also equals this. Okay, so let me store the array, the variables in here, right? So array. So I want to change the first name. So what I'll do, maybe, and then the second, the surname as well. This address and the ID. So PDO and execute. So let's try this and let me refresh this. Okay, so right here you can see it changes, right? So and it's left with one thing, which is the delete, and that one is very simple. So let's write another query, which is PDO equals the connects, and now the prepare. From PDO table, then where maybe ID equals this, right? Okay, so my array, but in here you can just do this PDO. Okay, right now our data has been deleted. So this is how you can insert, update and delete as well, right? So thank you for watching, and maybe our next tutorial I'll show you how you can build a crude operation using PDO, right? So, and these are the videos on my channel, right? You can visit and learn. So thank you for watching once again. Don't forget to click on the subscribe button.